Today I have an Illustrator Cliff text tutorial for you all to follow along with. It's fairly simple but a super cool Illustrator text effect. Welcome back to Satori Graphics, home of graphic design content. Hope you had a great weekend. I'm in the process of moving again, so things are a bit hectic here. I'm also thinking of doing my very first live stream this week, so let me know if that's something you guys want to see. Anyway, on with the Illustrator text effect tutorial. Create a new document in Illustrator and then type out your text and then create the outlines of the text. Grab the eraser tool and press Shift plus E on your keyboard. And then with the eraser tool, hold down Shift and click and drag to create a perfect horizontal line across your text. Then group your text and delete the bottom section. Then select the leftover shapes and hit Command G or Control G on a PC to group everything together. Then with the text selected, we're going to select the free transform option. Click and edit the corners so that the text seems to be on a flat surface like so. Grab the rectangle tool or press M on your keyboard and then make a rectangle across the entire artboard. Then send it to the back and change the color to any color that you want to use for your Illustrator text effect. Then change the text layer to white. With the pen tool, make a line across the bottom of your text, and then grab the white arrow tool, aka the direct selection tool, and drag the ends of the line to the edges of the artboard. Make sure the line runs perfectly along the bottom of your text. Once you've done that, use the pen tool again to continue the line around the artboard and make a triangle shape at the bottom. Add a gradient fill to the triangle. Deselect the triangle by clicking off of the artboard and then use the eyedropper tool to select the color of the background. Double click the color in the color palette and then highlight the color code and hit Command C or Control C on a PC to copy it. Now select the gradient triangle and in the gradient window, double click one of the color cells. Make sure it's set to RGB here and then paste in the color code. Do the same on the other side of the gradient too. And in the same color cell, go back in and change it to CMYK and put up the black slider a little bit. Using the pen tool, click the corner of your text and hold down Shift to make a perfectly straight line vertically like so. I forgot to drag a guide from the rulers on the side. If you didn't have the rulers open, hit Command R and they will pop up. Using Shift to make straight lines, finish the path to make the shape back up to the cliff text. You can use the direct selection tool to edit a path anytime. To speed things up, you can hold down Alt until you see this icon appear, and then click and drag to duplicate the shapes. Then use the direct selection tool to edit them. Use Alt on your keyboard to duplicate the bottom right triangle, and move it into place. We need to bring it to the front to make our Illustrator text effect complete. Take the direct selection tool and edit the triangle so that it perfectly fits on the artboard. Use the eyedropper tool to copy the color of the background. We have just a few finishing touches to make now. We're going to add a lighting effect on the bottom triangle. Duplicate the shape and then place it over the top. Add a gradient fill and then change both sides to white, but make one side of the gradient with 0% opacity and the other side set to something like 20%. You can go back and change the color of our gradients at any stage. I'm making the cliff face a little darker than before. And lastly, I want to change the shapes of the text that bleed down to a gradient. And there you have it, the Illustrator cliff text effect tutorial complete. I hope you all followed along and found it helpful. If you did, let me know in the comment section below. Like and share this video if you really did enjoy it, and subscribe for my 5 graphic design uploads per week. Until next time, design your future today. Peace.